I'm Jim Clark. Welcome to Basketball Weekly, talking with women's head coach Laurel Wartliff. Laurel, a couple of good games last week on the Ashland game Thursday. Everyone knows, rolling, unbeaten, number one team in the country. We played a very good ball game at their place in front of a big crowd, no signs of nervousness. I thought we played one of our best games of the year.
Right. Definitely was one of our best all-round games, both offensively and defensively. Just being able to stay focused on the court and run the plays is one of the biggest keys that we've had with our young team this year.
They've been beating folks by 30 and 40 without Kerry Doherty, one of the best players in the country, out. And yet they could never run a side of the gym or they felt comfortable having to be able to go to the bench early. Maybe they couldn't do that. Our girls really hung well.
Yes, we came out, and I knew the minute we hit the court and the first offensive possession for Ashland and we played great defense, I knew that right there put, I won't say a scare, but said that, you know, Walsh is here to play basketball and you're not going to run over us. And so I think that our players had a lot of pride in how we played, and we executed well. Both offensively and defensively, our problem was we got a little bit tired and ran out of gas down the stretch.
And that can carry over. Saturday, maybe not the same intensity with Lake Erie, but, you know, they felt they could win, and they did.
Right. We jumped out early on Lake Erie, and we were in control. And with a young team, I think that when you're able to do that, that helps them. But then on the flip side of that, when a few things go wrong, can you weather the storm? And coaches talk about four-minute wars and being able to battle momentum shifts and things like that. So we need to be able to do that and help our young players know that that's going to happen in every game and get them prepared for it so that we can battle in there.
That's a game the starter struggled a little bit. Some foul trouble. And you got great help off the bench from Sarah Stevenson and Tara Galoop.
Yes, I knew Sarah was going to be helpful to us. They were playing some zone and some doing a little pressing action, and she's very a cerebral player for us. And so that was just one of the things I knew going into the game. And then as the game evolved, I went to her right away, and she responded very, very well off the bench. Sarah did. Also, Tara Galoop did also. She hit a couple great baskets, just made some great cuts right down against the zone. And so those two both contributed well, and that's what we needed our bench players to do.
Back in action, home finally after the four-game road trip. I'm home, Ohio Dominican. Beat them down there, but they're playing better ball right now.
Yes, they are. They're playing much more intense and aggressive defensively and offensively. Everybody's stepping up. Their posts are doing a good job, posting up inside real strong. And so that we got to be ready when they come in here to defend our court.
Then Saturday, back on the road again. Six road games in seven games. We go to Tiffin. Beat them here, they'll be waiting.
They definitely be waiting for us with all the ammunition ready and loaded. So we need to just keep working hard and stepping up our intensity. And what we're trying to do, our motivation is to try and bring our best every game. And so we want to improve every week. And so that's what our motivation is right now. And I think that's why you saw when we went to Ashland, we were able to play as well as what we did. So each game, we're looking forward to doing that.
Thanks, Laurel. Good luck this week.
Thank you.
Women's basketball Thursday, 8 o'clock here against Ohio Dominican. Then Saturday on the road at Tiffin. That's at 3 o'clock. And Saturday's game will be broadcast live on 95.9 FM, WNPQ. I'm Jim Clark. That's Women's Basketball Weekly.